From a simple fist fight all the way to a full-blown bar fight, and heck, even all the way to a full-blown battle, violence is pretty much everywhere. For some, committing heinous acts of violence is enough to cause an adrenaline rush that quickly stifles all thoughts of common sense and replaces them with either the lust for blood or a lack of judgment. And then there are those who live for this rush. Psychopaths, serial killers, whatever you may call them. These people live for the kill. And, like Patrick Bateman from the movie American Psychopath, relish in its every moment.
You like Huey Lewis in the news?
They're okay.
Their early work was a little too new wave for my taste. But when Sports came out in 83, I think they really came into their own, commercially and artistically. The whole album has a clear, crisp sound and a new sheen of consummate professionalism that really gives the songs a big boost. He's been compared to Elvis Costello, but I think Huey has a far more bitter, cynical sense of humor.
Hey, Abstract.
Yes, Alan?
Why are there copies of the style section all over the place? Do you have a dog? A little chow or something?
No, Alan.
Is that a raincoat?
Yes, it is. In 87, Huey released this. Four, their most accomplished album. I think their undisputed masterpiece is Hip to Be Square. A song so catchy, most people probably don't listen to the lyrics. But they should, because it's not just about the pleasures of conformity and the importance of trends. It's also a personal statement about the band itself. Hey, Paul! Ah!
Spoiler alert, Paul doesn't survive the accident phase. Sorry, guys.
And while there are more instances of this in certain movies, I'll leave you to find them yourself. Just don't watch American History X unless you have a very strong stomach. Put it on the car right now!
That's it.
While Patrick Bateman or the curb stomp scene might seem like an extreme example of how violence affects how you act, it really isn't when put into perspective. All it requires is one date. 9/11/2001, to put this into perspective. A group of radical Muslims believe that they were the ones to bring America to its knees, and over the course of a few months of planning, organize the attack. Most people know what follow. However, with the war on terrorism starting, it became apparent that America is a world superpower for a reason. Just because you think crashing a plane into a building to send a message is a good idea doesn't mean that it is. Eventually, Al-Qaeda was eliminated, but at a cost. Violence isn't an answer to every problem, much like we treat it. Violence only brings more problems to the table. It is not the end-all solution people think it is. And even when it seems the most proper way to deal with something, there is always a better way.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself,